Welcome everyone on a perfect night for football with the floodlights beaming down. I'm Derek Ray, in position to bring you live match commentary, and my expert analyst, as always on these occasions, is Stuart Robson. I'm looking forward to bringing you action from the Carabao Cup. It's the Dons, and they take on Bolton Wanderers.
Yes, cheers, Derek. Well, what an occasion it is for this club and its supporters. These are the games that they dream of. No doubt in there, the underdogs. But if they can frustrate their opponents, stay in the game up until half-time, you just never know. Hopefully we get a great cup tie and maybe even a massive surprise.
Well, the attacking options appear plentiful and good pressure high up the pitch. Defensive efficiency personified. Making progress. And teammates to play it to. Well read to ease the pressure.
A reminder that the reserves are in action tomorrow. If you'd like more ticket details, have a look at the club website or contact the ticket office for more information.
Well, they're moving the ball neatly enough. Just looking for that decisive pass. Good technique displayed. It might be. He's foiled them on his own. Guy. Well, real difficulty keeping the ball. And they need to get tighter here. And options in the centre. Well, that's how to put in a clean tackle. Perry. Could be threatening. Dangerous looking attack. High quality defending. Kieran Lee. Keeping possession of the ball with authority. Well, the goalkeeper doing what he's paid to do. The concession of a corner here. Delivering it. Not the best clearance. Oh, is he going to be punished here? Opportunity. Oh, disappointing. Just when it looked like a surefire opener.
Well, that should have been the opener, Derek. I'm not sure how he's missed that.
Oakley. Perry. Disappointing pass. Definitely look as though they want to make this move count. And he's in. Oh, yes! 1-0 it is! And it doesn't come as a huge surprise. So the Dons get things restarted. Let's see if they can wipe out that last goal. Guy. Keeping the ball moving. Perry. Really good challenge. Opportunity. And a goal to square the game. Edge of the seat stuff.
Well, here's the replay. Watch how he goes past his man with such ease, and it's just a change of pace. And the finish is just as good. That's an excellent goal. Well, as you can see, the visitors have had most of the ball, but their attacking players lack tempo, invention, and guile. that's something they need to rectify quickly if they're going to win this one.
Well, they know they need to stop him. Can he put them in front? Yes, is the emphatic answer. And you have to say, it was on the cards. So on with the match. 2-1 is the scoreline. What's going to happen next? Going about his defensive business with a minimum of fuss. Well, getting close to the half-time interval, and the story so far, they're not really making home advantage count. Stuart, your take.
Well, it's been a good game, but they've been second best in a couple of key areas. That needs to change in the second half, otherwise it's going to be a disappointing result for them.
It needs an accurate cross. Can they convert? It has to be, surely. That's great goalkeeping.
Well, what a save that is. He was so alert there.
Well, goalkeeper mistake. Will there be a price to pay? Decent position. Element of risk there, but he's won the ball. 1 minute of any time. A chance then for the respective managers to address their charges. So the ball is rolling again, and work to do for the Dons here. Hills. Now, will they be able to play it in behind the defence? And he takes it on. Body in the way. Now, there's been so much talk about a potential transfer, but it's potential no more. It's fact.
Well, the figure that's being quoted is around the £35 million mark, which in my view looks to be just about right. Let's hope he fits in quickly and justifies that price tag.
Guy. The Dons might be able to cash in. Could be dangerous. Just not looking confident in possession. Dempsey. Good vision. Can he get onto this? Teammate available. And they couldn't add to their advantage.
Well, that would have put them in complete control. He should have... scored there.
They decided that now is the time to go to the bench. Oakley. And Ward with it. And the attacking options appear plentiful. But really sticking to their task defensively. You certainly have got to give this man high marks for his work up to this point, Stuart.
Well, it's been an incredible performance from him. Clearly the difference between the two sides. Obviously the goals, but his movement too. He's causing the backline all sorts of headaches. He'll no doubt be desperate to grab the hat-trick now.
Jón Daði Böðvarsson.
Well, potential danger. In position. Can he finish? It's a neat move. And nodding it just over the top. Well, we have 20 minutes left in this game. Well, a really single-minded piece of defending to make sure nothing untoward happened. Throw-ins given. Oakley. Ward now. Decent position for the Dons to be in. Well, it looked highly promising, but they got nothing out of it. Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break. Jón Daði Böðvarsson. And teammates to play it to. Cuts it back. Real chance. It's in. They're looking really relaxed and confident and not giving the opposition much of a look in. So there it is. 3-1 the current scoreline here. Ten minutes left for play. And Ward with it. Putting his body on the line. Nicely cut out. In with a chance. Majestic piece of goalkeeping.
Well, he loves the big moments, doesn't he? And he's proved it again there. Great goalkeeping.
Playing it in. Well, he took care of it defensively. About the outcome, surely they now have been removed. Ward now. Oakley. It's with Ward. Well, that effort was always going wide. He's not going to be best pleased with himself. Dempsey. There's the final whistle. The travelling fans are full of the joys because they are keeping possession of the ball. Hello everyone. You know, some footballers enjoy a rainy day. Not sure fans always feel that way, but an exciting match in prospect nonetheless. I'm your match commentator, Derek Ray, at the microphone, and sitting alongside me is the former Arsenal, West Ham and Coventry midfield player, Stuart Robson. I'm very much ready to bring you the cut and thrust of League Two. It's Bradford City up against the Dons. And the cross goes in, and he dealt with that ball played in rather well. Good technique displayed. Chance here. And both hands on it. Good goalkeeping. Well, this is the day, his debut forthcoming, and it's going to be fascinating to see what he produces. Stuart, what do you think we should expect to see from him?
Well, I think he's a really good defender. He makes timely interceptions, he makes the right decisions about when to squeeze up and when to drop off, and he's decent in the air. But he'll need to form an understanding with his teammates quickly, and that's not always easy.
Well, that's wonderful attacking play. So the Dons get things restarted. Let's see if they can wipe out that last goal. And the pass could do damage. Well, he really read that brilliantly. And an effective clearance. Well, he stopped them just when they looked menacing. Well, they've won the ball back quickly. Making progress. Could play it in. Couldn't find a teammate. Throw in here. Now, the situation has changed in one of the other games I'm hearing. Let's go to Alex Scott.
Yep, it's a goal for Newport County. After a well-worked move, he got himself on the end of a cross with a beautiful header. It's now 1-0 with 23 minutes played.
Alex, thank you very much. Hills. Slipshod passing. Cook. Oh, great vision. He knows he's got to react. And he saw the situation developing. And space to cross it. Can they convert? Really important tackle. Who can they pick out? Well, the header needed to be a lot better than that. Didn't really make the keeper work. A good effective pressure high up the pitch. Hills. Good looking ball. He takes aim. And he's done it. Parity again. A magnificent game unfolding.
Well, here it is again. He hits this so sweetly, doesn't he? That's a brilliant goal from a top-class player.
So underway again here on the back of that leveller. Cook. Now we have a goal to tell you about in one of the other games. Here's Alex Scott.
It's a goal for Salford City, but it was a poor clearance.
Can he give them the lead?
And up a cul-de-sac in terms of the attack. Well, we're sorry for interrupting you just then, Alex. To confirm for you, the visitors did score in that match, and their lead stands at 1-0 presently. Cross could be useful.
Wonderful to have that in your repertoire.
Well, here it is again, and what a perfect cross into the box this is. Just invited someone to attack it, and then what a finish. That's been hit with such power and pace, the keeper has no time to react. It's a brilliant strike.
So the ball is rolling again, 2-1 the scoreline. Well, there is going to be stoppage time, but only the 1 minute. Into the advanced position. And space for the cross. Can he convert? Determined defending. A chance then for the respective managers to... The two teams have switched around and are ready now for the second half. Just looking for the right moment for that final pass. And players waiting in the centre. That was perfectly timed, and it is going to be a corner. Trying to pick out a teammate. Can he put it away? Surely the equaliser. That is a tackle and a half. A very significant transfer story has broken. Mats Hummels has completed his move to Chelsea.
Well, the reported fee of about £40 million is just about right. I think both clubs will feel they've done well out of this one, but only time will tell.
He could pick out a teammate. Well, harried into losing the ball. Really effective pressing. Here it is now, a substitution. Well, keeping hold of the ball is what it's all about for them. And successfully cut out. Sutton. Nicely cut out. That's a good looking ball. It looks promising. This could be the equaliser. Well, last gasp defending, but brilliant defending. And it goes! The leveller! Thrilling!
off here.
Well, as you can see, this is a wonderful strike. He makes the perfect connection, and he has so much pace on it. It's a great goal.
You've really got to give credit to the entire team, because this was a bit like climbing Mount Everest. Well, I believe a spot kick award in one of the other games. Let's hear all about it from Alex.
Yeah, Exeter City were awarded the penalty. I think he gave him the eyes because he sent the keeper totally the wrong way. It's now 1-1 with 65 minutes played.
Thanks as always to Alex Scott. Well, possibilities inside the box. They really look after the ball when they have it. Playing with purpose and control. Promising possession, this. That's well blocked. The outcome is a goal kick here. Sutton. At times they make passing look easy. Can he open the door to a potential goal? Can they forge ahead? He's blocked it and denied by the post. Well, the keeper can breathe a big sigh of relief.
Well, he can. That was so unlucky. How close was that? Well, you sense the goal's coming. They're getting so close now. They just need to take one of these chances.
Moving the ball forward with purpose. Giving it a try. Body in the way. Just can't get it past them. And it crossed the touchline, so a throw in here. And crossed in there. Uncomfortable in dealing with the ball played in. Now, I believe changing circumstances in one of the other games. Alex Scott will tell us more.
Yeah.
metanina, you know the metabala. I in the metanina, you know the metabala. I in the metanina, Diana, you know the metabala, dondo. Then Kulia, Nagaye, then Sulia, Nagaye, Ponyako, Nagaye, then Kunia, Nagaye. Metanina diana nina ode metabala dondo.
was just 18, boy with a dream. In love with the flow, with the sight on the scene. Not many know what it's like to be seen, but I'm getting to know now, to know now. Just 18, little black boy with a dream. With the craziest mind and the lowest esteem. Trying to find what happens at the highest esteem. So I had a dream and a couple call me extreme. I was thinking about what can make me better, cause these terms are cool, never made me clever. Too cool a fool to retain that error. I was trying to be great, they were telling me never. So, got a craft with the work in it. A couple had a laugh when they saw me working it. And I was trash at the start and I stunk like a fart. But the heart in my work got me murking it. And I was 5 years gone, I've been doing it strong. Working night till dawn and they singing my song. Nobody telling me I'm doing it wrong, cause I was telling them that really I'm just 18. Boy with a dream, in love with the flow, with the sight and the scene. Not many know what it's like to be seen, but I'm getting to know now, to know now. Just 18, boy with a dream, in love with the flow, with the sight and the scene. Not many know what it's like to be seen, but I'm getting to know now, to know now. Just 18, little black brother with a dream. That's faced and placed in a diabolical regime. That made it seem like I was never part of the team, but I was David. Never let it ruin the dream, cause I was hitting up a giant that was bigger than Moses, bigger than me. Couldn't see the ghost is living in me, cause I was just a relevant host with a degree. You could say I was better than most, cause I kept on working, put the time in. Though they hate, see I kept on shining. Now the flow's dividing, ultrasounding, and I will never stop trying. I'm tightening until the flow get them shook like lightning and make the smile in their face excitement. See, I was told that's my one assignment, and now I'm telling them that really I'm just 18. Boy with a dream, in love with the flow, with the sight and the scene. Not many know what it's like to be seen, but I'm getting to know now, to know now. Just 18, boy with a dream, in love with the flow, with the sight and the scene. Not many know what it's like to be seen, but I'm getting to know now, to know now. Just 18, just 18, started at 16, with a dream so big, no self-esteem.
And a warm welcome on what is an ideal night for football, you've got to say. I'm Derek Ray, and my commentary partner, as always, is Stuart Robson. And our live coverage comes to you from League Two. It's Bristol Rovers up against the Dons.
Yes, thanks as always, Derek. We've got two good teams here, so I'm anticipating a really good game. The atmosphere is electric inside the stadium before kickoff, and hopefully we're not disappointed.
Not away completely. Oh, moving it nicely. Clean challenge. Guy, can they create something from here? Perry. Could be! And a goal! To open the scoring, a very bright start to this one.
Well, I have to say, this is a really good goal. Just watch his technique here. He just hits through the back of the ball with such power. There's no stopping that.
So, underway again here. 1-0 the score. Finlay. Nolan. And you can sense the threat is there. John Nolan. Well, that pass easy on the eye.
And it goes to square the game. What a contest this is turning out to be.
So back underway. They've levelled it at 1-1 here.
Sam Nicholson.
How about the cross? Well, racing past his man. Oakley. Perry. Might be able to get in behind the defence. Oh, a fine block. And it's gone behind for the corner. And there's the delivery. And still dangerous. Good John's move in the making. Well, nothing comes of it. It looked promising. There's a slide rule pass. The pressure was on the keeper following the threaded pass.
Just failing to hit the target with his pass, and it'll be a throw-in. Finlay.
Can he make it count? Well, he didn't miss by all that much. Wide in the end.
With the owner of the blue car,
Evans. He read the situation defensively and did his job.
Encouraging move from the Don's point of view. Very alert defending to put a stop to the chance. Well, the situation has changed in one of the other games. Here's Alex Scott with the news.
It's a goal for Salford City. They've scored the opener here with 31 minutes on the clock. This is what we love to see. Back to you, Derek.
Thank you, Alex.
Could be. Oh, my goodness. He's caught that. A goal of the highest class. Fantastic technique.
So the action continues, and the onus is on the Dons to erase the damage done by that concession. Perry. Guy. Just made sure nothing came of that. Corner for the Dons. What can they do with the set piece? Corner kick played in. And it was pretty straightforward for the goalkeeper. Well, I'm hearing there's been a goal in one of the other games, and Alex Scott can fill us in.
It's a goal for Harrogate Town. It's now 1-0 with 39 minutes on the clock. What a game of football we have on our hands here today, Derek.
Alex with the info as ever. Well, they've given him too much space, but it fizzles out thanks to that piece of defending.
Well, the counter chance looks very real. And he's outdone himself. Wonderful save there. And now the delivery. Not really the ideal clearance.
And into the clutches of the goalkeeper. Well, just 1 minute of time added on for stoppages here. Finlay.
A chance then for the respective managers to...
So the ball is rolling again, and work to do for the Dons here.
Plenty of players waiting in the middle. Oh, that's a really good run.
Well, he has cause to be grateful to his teammate.
Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? All hands on deck.
Lovely ball over the top.
High echelon goalkeeping there.
And a short corner, let's see. Will it happen for them? And a tidy tackle.
It should be! Very clear who got the last touch, so a corner coming up.
Playing it in.
A very effective clearance. Anderton. Can they convert? No hiding from the fact that they really should have extended their lead.
Well, that was a poor miss. Could they come to regret that?
There's been so much speculation in terms of whether the transfer would go ahead, but it will go ahead, Stuart.
Well, he'll certainly bring a lot of know-how to this team, and of course quality. I think he's still got a lot to offer, and it's a shrewd bit of business.
Beautifully disguised ball. Such an important goalkeeping intervention under pressure. Perry. Thirty minutes left for play. Excellent assessment of the situation at the back. Now we have a goal to tell you about in one of the other games. Here's Alex Scott.
Yep, it's a goal for Leyton Orient. The score's level again now at 1-1 with 63 minutes played.
Thanks as always to Alex Scott. Perry. Middleton. Possession and patience, the watchwords. It's there for him, and it's in! All square again. What a match this is turning out to be.
Well, let's take another look, and wow, how cleanly does he hit that? The keeper was never going to save it. What a good goal that is.
Well, you've really got to give credit to the entire team, because this was a bit like climbing Mount Everest. And the emphasis is on creativity. Opportunity to take the lead. And up for grabs off the keeper. Well, nothing comes of it. A goal has been scored in one of the other games. Alex Scott has the news.
Build-up play for me, so many different players involved, and once the space opened up, he took his chance superbly. They're ahead by two now with 71 minutes played.
Many thanks, Alex. Looking confident with the ball at his feet. Well, time just challenged magnificently. Can he take advantage? Pulls it back. And a very good challenge. Well, I must say he acquitted himself well under pressure. Opportunity here. A top save, and that keeps it all square.
Well, you're right. Derek, a top-class save, and such an important one as well. That surely would have been it had it gone in.
And he's fired over the corner. No-nonsense clearance. This is looking threatening. Perry.
Wins it for them. There's every chance, and the fans are laughing this up.
Well, here you can see it again. Good run, great strength, and a composed finish under pressure. That's a top-class goal.
What a big moment in the dying embers. Will it prove decisive here? They get forward, but time is very much against them here. Doing well to keep possession. Lovely work to get past his man. Cuts it back. Oh, good reflexes from the keeper, and the danger averted. Time really is of the essence. What can they do from this situation? And over it comes. Well, it has come to nothing. Good save.
And 3 minutes will be added on for stoppages. And that is that. The referee blows his whistle for full time.
Me escucho con Dion Piccolo, loco mirando fui a la escuela, les estoy dando para el pelo, aunque a tu soldado ya le duela, noche con maleta por correr, fuga la ventana del Manolo, al tiempo más voy queriéndolo, el dinero también voy amándolo, cuando ya te coja vaya tela, parecía como de novela, ay loco no fui a la escuela. Pero sí que aprendí. Olega quiere comprar una casa, mamá. Lo soñaba cuando trepaba ventana. Fiesta a punto pase de la. Él lo guarda porque es el que lo gana. Y no pienses ni siquiera en mañana. A no ser que tú te vayas a caer en cana. Y si piensas en mañana, vive rodeado de paredes y una ventana. Agradecido porque tengo una cena. Y calentito cuando quiero una cama. Y no envidio pa' que otro tenga fama. Hablan de lejos y de frente. Y tu padre facha me llamaría Mena. Y yo pago los impuestos por lo menos. Un racista que critica todos mis temas. Es porque su hija se enamoró de un nene. De una sociedad donde lo repelen. Y no quieren que tengamos el sonido. El miedo que abrirle a todos los ojos. Palabras que se quedaron en el olvido.
Hello everyone and welcome. What we can't complain about today is the weather. Absolutely perfect playing conditions. I'm Derek Ray in the commentary position and I'm joined for analysis by Stuart Robson. I'm very excited to be able to bring you live action from League Two coming up. It's the Dons taking on Colchester United.
Well, Derek, when looking forward to this game, you can't help but notice there are some great matchups all over the pitch, particularly in those central areas. Whichever team wins more of those battles will win the game.
Now, someone has scored in one of the other matches. Let's find out exactly who. Alex Scott will tell us.
It's a goal for Exeter City. He shot far post, the keeper parries it, but the rebound has been put in nicely. It's now 1-0 with only 2 minutes played.
Thanks as always, Alex. Oh, the threat is there. And he really read that brilliantly. Edwards. Oh, showing excellent vision. Well, nothing comes of the attack when all is said and done. And they need to get tighter here. Working away patiently, looking for an opening. That's a nice looking ball. Foiling them effectively. Well, I'm hearing there's been a goal in one of the other games, and Alex Scott can fill us in.
Yeah, it's a goal for Leighton Orient. The free kick was well executed, but it had a big deflection, and it's gone in off the wall. They've scored the opener here with 13 minutes played.
Alex keeping us right up to date.
Must take the lead here. Oh, but he's missed it. How on earth is this still level?
Well, I just don't know, Derek. Just a real lack of composure in the end. They should be ahead now.
Sears. Still pushing for that goal that would see them forge ahead. Beautifully weighted ball. Well, nothing comes of it. Can he play it in? Edwards. A glorious chance. And a goal! 1-0 it is. They've been pushing for the opener, and now they have it. 1-0 then.
Luke Hammond.
Well, we have a goal to tell you about in one of the other matches. Alex has the news.
It's a goal for Salford City. It's now 1-0 with 25 minutes on the clock.
Many thanks as ever, Alex. A really top-notch piece of defending. Tremendous ball played through. And the challenge halts them in their tracks. Oh, big opportunity! Well, it really wasn't a great effort, was it? Strong but fair tackle. Sears. They do pass the ball with authority. Well, it all counts for naught.
Well, as you can see, the hosts have had most of the ball, but they aren't doing enough with it. They need to pass it quicker, play forward earlier, and
now, hold on, Stuart. They're in here. Couldn't quite hang on. Second chance, goalkeeper error. Back underway, level pegging, one goal apiece in this game. Keeping possession of the ball with authority. Sears. Plenty of players waiting in the middle. Well, someone has scored in one of the other games. Must be! And there is the goal to re-establish their advantage! So the Dons get things restarted. Let's see if they can wipe out that last goal. Just 1 minute of stoppage time, say the officials. Could be dangerous, putting his body on the line. And the managers will now deliver their half-time. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Excuse. Now I'm hearing that something has happened in one of the other venues. A goal there. Alex Scott with the news.
It's a goal for Bristol Rovers. It was a nice pullback, a low driven shot. They couldn't do anything about that one. It's all even Stevens at 1-1 with 46 minutes played.
Alex with the info as ever. Now, there's been so much talk about a potential transfer, but it's potential no more. It's fact.
Well, I think it's a good move for him. He has great ability, but needs to be that little bit more consistent. I'd say it's a fair price as well.
Interception to snuff out the danger. Now can they counter clinically? Excellent vision. And a goal! Real excitement here, the equaliser.
Well, let's see this again. The vision to play this through ball is superb, but the keeper should do better at his near post. That's gone in far too easily. That's not good goalkeeping.
Well, another equaliser. What a topsy-turvy game this has been. Skews. Sears. It might be on for them. And a tidy challenge. Well, a goal update for us to know about. Let's hear more from Alex Scott.
Yep, it's a goal for Swindon Town. It was a low-driven cross into a crowded area, but he was...
Can he give them the lead? Well, the keeper had plenty to think about with bodies around him. Well, we never like cutting off Alex, but sometimes we have to do it for understandable reasons when things are happening. To confirm for you, the visitors did score in that match, and the match is level at 1-1. Wilson with it. Oakley. Good use of the ball, but can they trouble the defence? Perry. Oh, tremendous block. Well, news of a goal in one of the other matches. Over to Alex Scott.
It's another goal for Bristol Rovers. They now lead 3-2 with 68 minutes played.
Alex, thank you very much. Must score! There it is! A fantastic goal, and no wonder he's off celebrating! Well, a dramatic moment near the end, and that might well be the decider. Just failing. To hit the target with his pass, and it'll be a throw-in. Chambers. Cole Skews. Well, we're inside the final quarter of an hour now. Well, I'm hearing the referee has pointed to the penalty spot in one of the other games. Let's hear more about it from Alex.
Well, Bristol Rovers were awarded the penalty.
Oh, in with a chance. Well, it might still work out for them. In it goes. That will greatly help their cause. Now they only need to keep concentration levels high. So the current scoreline, 4-2. Freddie Sears. Beautifully disguised ball. Still looking to get the shot off. Plays it back. Great defending. Oh my goodness! He's caught that so well! A goal of the highest class. Fantastic technique. It's a massive lead, and it's very hard to imagine them losing it now. Well, time for a scoring update because things are changing. Let's hear all about it from Alex Scott.
It's another goal for Bristol Rovers. It's now 4-3 with just under 10 minutes left to play.
Many thanks, Alex. 5 minutes left. Sears. Edwards. Chance here. The net is staring him in the face. It's opening up for them. Oh, that is a majestic goal! Volleyed home with precision and style. Superbly done.
Colchester United, number 8, Cole Skews.
Just 1 minute of stoppage time, say the officials. And that is the end of the game. It goes into the history books as a home defeat.